Today we will discuss concept of SQL Loader. What is the SQL Loader? What are the different types? What are the different files that are used in SQL Loader? And how we can use the SQL Loader? So SQL Loader, we have to load the data from the different external files and to the Oracle database tables. That is a powerful data parsing engine that put little limitation on the format of the data and now data files. Whenever we are having SQL loaders, we have to load the data from the different files to one tables or different tables at the same load sessions. At one time we can load data from the different files. Right, mean multiple file may be there. From multiple files, data files, we have to load the data into more than one tables at the same times. So for that ones, when we discuss concept of SQL loader, in SQL loaders, we have five main type of files are available. First one is input data file. In input data files, we see that the file that contains the data. We are having any file. That file may be in the comma separated value. That may be in the txt file format. That may be in the date format. Right? CSV, txt, date, or any other file format is there. So to take data, to collect data from the different data files, that is we are using concept of data files. So it means source files that is available in the txt, CSV or any other file format. After that one, we are having concept of the control files. Control file, we are having the two different types. In control files, we can perform the three main type of operation. Insert, like that define. We are having the data is available. We see that if we are having the table is available in the database. If table don't have the data, for that one, if new table is there, then we can use in control file the insert operations, insert into table names, or it may be possible if table having the data, we want to remove all the data. For that one, we have to use the truncate in control file, and third one, we have to use append. If we don't want to remove, if we have the data and we don't want to remove the data, we want to add new data with the current existing data. So for that one we have to use the concept of append. So in control files we have to load the data, and for that one we have to use the three main type of command over there. One, insert, truncate and append. Insert, whenever table is empty, we have to use the insert truncate. If we have a data in table and we want to remove all the data, then we have to use the truncate. And last one option, that is append, mean we want to attach the data with the previous data. As we see that data files, we have to take the data from the different sources. So for that one, we are having two main types over here. If we are using CSV file format, comma separated value, so for that one we are having format is here. One is the we have to use the delimiter, or second one we have to use the fixed length format, fixed format length we have to use it over there. Okay, next one we are having the log files that contain all the information, what are the different file is there, what are the different data is available in each and other. Bad files that contain the file data not accepted, the data that is not accepted, the data that due to some reason we may not be able to load it into the database table, that will move to the bad file. Discarded files, the data due to some business logic we may not be able to move it into the database, that is our discard files. So we are having more information over here in this slide. SQL loader, read data from one or more files specified in control file. From SQL loaders, the data in the data file is organized as record. So we are having the formats CSV, DAT, TXT. So we have two main types of data files: delimiter separators or fixed positions file. If you are using concept of the delimiters, then in delimiter we can use it over here. Let me say that employee ID 1, comma, Ali, then comma, let clerk, right? Similarly, other information may be yes. Okay. Fixed position, let me say that we are having the fixed position for the columns. 2 characters for the first column, 3-5 characters for the second column, third column we are having 10 characters are there. We have to define it over there. We will explain it later on. Control files, used for loading the data, provide the interface between the data file and the tables. SQL loaders, for the control file we may have the extension .ctl. In control file, different operation data performed, insert, truncate, and append. Log file provides the information about the process of loading from the data file to database. Complete information that will be available, and that extension is .txt. Then we are having bad file. In bad file, the name of the file created by the SQL loader to store the record. Due to some errors during the insertion of the data, and we may not be able to insert that one data. Bad file is automatically created if they are not no rejected records. For that one, extension is .bad. Now we are having discard file, business logics. When condition of where clause is not true, extension of .dsc will be used over there. So these are the main files. Now we will discuss how in next video we will discuss how we can use or how we can practically implement all of these data over here.